Well, Splash the sea snail has finally come out of his shell. Phew! Splash, you've got to stop eating those garlic kelp munchies in bed. I'm sure glad that I'm not the cleaner shrimp who has to brush your teeth this morning.
Now, as you are all aware, this is a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. What would the ocean be without cleaner shrimp? This brigade has a sparkling reputation, built and maintained to the highest standards. Are we going to let Plaque get the upper fin?
Sir, no, sir!
Do we have the courage to clean beneath the deepest gum line?
Sir, yes, sir!
All right then, brigade, go in there and make me proud!
It was the back right molar, Sergeant Bristle, sir. I've never seen anything like it, sir.
There, there, Corporal. Buck up. There may be a medal for you in this.
Splash, Coral, hurry up, you two. Don't forget our nature swim with the Reef Park Ranger this morning.
Okay, Mom.
We're coming.
This area with my parents when I was a small fry, too.
Your Grandpa Finley wanted you to be named Coral because he thought you were as pretty as a coral reef.
Oh, look, there's the park ranger. He's already started his nature talk.
We're swimming, we're swimming, we're swimming, we stop. Now, ladies and gentlefish, what we have here is a section of coral reef that was completely wiped out by the red tide of 56. As you can see...
Excuse me, Mr. Ranger, sir. What is a red tide?
Well, young ladyfish, no one, not even our top fin scientists, understand it completely. But sometimes, very mysteriously, the tide water turns crimson red and carries a poison so terrible that nothing survives. Now, if you'll...
You mean it kills the coral and the fish and everything?
That's right, Sonny. Now, if there are no more interruptions, questions... We're swimming.
What about King Pacificus? Would the red tide hurt him?
It would break his heart, but I don't think it would threaten his life.
Thank you.
creeper. I'll try to pull it off of you.
Justin, do you know what will happen if you drop the tube of uranium hydrohelium nulliquadium?
You mean the thing?
Yeah, Krustin, the thing!
Boom?
That's right. Boom!
You mean like last time?
Yeah, like last time. Do not drop the exploding thing.
No, Professor Pinch.
Ugh, you give me headaches.
Yes, Professor Pinch.
In fact, I don't even like you.
Yes, Professor Pinch.
Do you want me to take you back to the cold, lonely tide pool where I found you? Nobody else wanted you either.
No, Professor Pinch.
Creeper! Ah! Do you have the colonial cilantroate I sent you to get?
This thing?
Yeah, that thing. Bring it to me.
Watch out. He's not called Professor Pinch for nothing.
Thanks.
Now, I shall test and see if my red tide poison is ready.
I will be the one to do the testing. Ah, much better, don't you think? All that color and beauty has become quite tedious. But Pinch, is there enough poison here to create a red tide large enough to destroy the entire coral reef?
Oh yes, more than enough.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's release the red tide now! I've seen narwhals circling above the secret entrance. They may suspect something and are sure to report to Pacificus.
Patience, patience. We must wait until the tide turns towards the coral reef so that the red tide poison can be concentrated on the reef village. Yes. Yes! Yes! Creeper, be a good little spy and report immediately when the tide turns toward the reef.
Yes, oh, mean one. Esteemed one?
Oh, and Creeper, be sure to hurry back inside the laboratory before the ocean turns red, or you will be in the wrong place at the wrong tide. And you, get out there and keep watch.
I'm stuck. I can't do anything right.
I must confess, I've made a mess of it. Now I'm so lonely and scared. Guess you could say that's just the way it is.
you can clearly see. Excuse me. Now, don't panic. I've just received an emergency announcement, which I wish to announce. King Pacificus has asked all reef fish to gather in the Reef Village Center. Krakken and his cohort, Professor Pinch, have concocted a plan to release a red tide that, if they succeed, will wipe out our entire village!
Oh, no!
Not a red tide!
Help! Now, if you'll just follow me, we'll move in an orderly fashion to the Reef Village Center. We're swimming! We're swimming! We're swimming! We're stampeding! We're stampeding!
Finrick, what about Grandpa Finley? Is there time?
You go to the Reef Village Center. I'll go get Grandpa. We'll meet you there.
Please, quiet yourselves. As you know, a deadly red tide is approaching this village. Soon you will need to take refuge inside of me. I will hold you gently in my mouth.
What if he swallows us?
Do we dare?
I don't know. He's so big, and we're so small.
No harm will come to you. The red tide will not kill me, and you'll be safe only by hiding in me. You must gather living coral samples to be brought into safety with you. Now try to find as many different kinds as you can. Don't stray too far. And hurry. Splash, Coral, are you brave and do you trust me?
Yes, Your Majesty.
I need you to do something for me. There's someone who needs my help, but I cannot go. My size and power will only frighten him.
Yes, Your Majesty. We'll go.
I'm sorry to rush you, Grandpa, but we still have a long way to go, and we're running out of time.
Sorry. The old fins just aren't what they used to be. I'll try to move faster.
Krusten, what kind of mess are you in now?
Oh, just the usual kind. Only this time I'm really stuck.
I'd help you, but I gotta go tell Krakken. The tide's turning, and you know how grumpy he gets when you don't do what he says.
I know. I hate that.
Well, it was nice knowing you. Bye-bye. Uh-oh.
So, you were going to hurry inside and leave your little friend out here to suffer the red tide in his trap all alone? I like that. It shows the nasty, treacherous qualities that I'm looking for in my spies. You may make a good bad guy yet, Creeper. Now, the tide has turned, and the time has come to release the poison!
Krusten, I don't know why I'm doing this. Oh, but maybe if I hurry, we can both die. Try to make it.
Thanks, Creeper. I owe ya. I didn't think you cared about.
Hey, don't turn soft shell on me. If you tell Krakken I did this, I'll dunk your head in the red tide myself.
Thanks, Creeper.
Krakken! No!
It is time for you to take refuge. Hide yourselves inside me and you'll be safe from the red tide.
Believe that King Pacificus wants us to go rescue crabs. Doesn't he know they're Krakken spies?
And look, I've seen one of them before. He's a spy, all right. That's Creeper. He's always helping Krakken with his dirty work.
What do you want?
King Pacificus has sent us to find you. For some reason, he wants to save you two from the red tide.
How do we know he doesn't just want to eat us?
I know a trap when I fall into one.
King Pacificus isn't like that. He's kind and gentle, and he never says something he doesn't mean.
Look, there's no time to argue. You could come with us, or you could die here with the red tide.
All right, but you two swim ahead of us. And no tricks.
Follow closely and hurry up. We don't want to be too late to enter the king's mouth.
I don't like the sound of this. I thought I heard him say, enter the king's mouth. Did he say mouth, Creeper?
Grandpa, you made it!
Oh, we're glad to see you too.
What are those two scallywags doing here?
The king sent us to get them.
Then he has a reason.
Hey, you two don't belong. We don't want any of Krakken spies in here.
No crabs allowed.
What's the matter? Krakken doesn't want you either?
That's enough. The king has asked them here. That should be enough for you. Now, stay close and don't cause any trouble.
Now I know what Corporal Scumcheck and the Cleaner Brigade feel like.
Everyone, I want you to gather around. Now take the living coral samples you've gathered and replant them into the ocean floor.
Excuse me, Your Majesty. Even with all we've gathered,
It's not enough. It takes generations for a reef to grow.
Fenric Splash Finley II?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Plant a small bit of coral.
Healthier and more nauseatingly beautiful than before. What did you put in that poison? Fertilizer?
Now, now, Krakken. Temper, temper. I can explain.
Won't you stay, Krusten?
You mean you really want me?
Yes.
Wow, that would be wonderful. Nobody ever really wanted me before. I don't think your fish friends really like me too much, though.
Well, you would have to earn their trust. You've hurt them by helping Krakken and Professor Pinch.
But I gotta go find Creeper. He saved me.
He got you out of a tough situation, Krusten. But being saved is something much more than that.
Maybe. I gotta go.
Well, look at that. Those crabs didn't even say thank you.
We don't understand, Your Majesty.
Yeah. Why did you rescue them? They'll just cause more trouble later.
I forgave you, didn't I?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Remember that when it's hard to forgive others. Now, let's go join the celebration, shall we?
Okay. Yeah, that sounds great.
Okay, let's go!